it's like a uplifting, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could either go into PGs and do your thing and like beat yourself up about it if you don't get it right, or you can learn from it. So with PGs, I was able to go in there and test myself out and really push myself to the limit, you know what I mean? So without PGs, like, I wouldn't be as known as I am right now. Wow. Real talk. PGs, like, help shape me who I am, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a part of Kilo Gaddafi, like, no doubt.
Made me feel like I was family, and eventually I just end up.
It's so crazy that, like, it's so hard for this place to stay afloat, because, like, I don't understand. It's just like it's the only place for this thing to happen.
Closer to a lot of people at PG than I am to some people in my family, you know, like a lot of people in my family. So I lost a friend early this year, and if it weren't for my PG family, I don't know where I'd be. I'd be wilding out, you know. So, you know, everybody had my back then, you know, so, still do, and they're just, it's a lot of good people, man.
I had heard about PG and decided to check it out. And so when I came here, I felt at home. I could feel the energy of everyone that was there, that was attending, and it was like, come as you are, and be who you are, and do what you do. And I continuously kept coming back. Sometimes I walk in here, and I don't even know if I'm seen. And other times I walk in here, because things outside of here are not going right. And somebody starts a conversation with me, and I don't feel alone anymore. I don't know where anywhere else in town that can do that.
I was hooked on PGs from the beginning, you know what I'm saying? Because it, you know, it ain't like a rah-rah club, one of those bars. It's like real chill, and it like goes through like different elements. Like when you walk in, it's like a lounge. It's like, I just want to chill here, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then you go back and you got your, you know, bar set up. And then you got this live, this big empty room full of speakers and all the stuff I'm attracted to. So it's always like a chill vibe and shit, and I liked it.
It's that whole hometown small venue, and it's like they're watching you jam at your practice space, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, it has that, no, it's kind of cool. I love it.
You will never feel awkward here. No one ever feels awkward. It's like, you know, it's beautiful. And a lot of it is the energy of the people, the collective mindset of people who just want to create and make something nice, make something dope, you know. And when everybody connects with that, you can have 5 people or you can have 100 people in there and they're all going to rock with you.
And like, I have been coming to Evansville for shows since I was like 15. And like, every venue has always provided a space like the way this place did, like for people to do what they do. But PG was so unique because it encompasses everybody and includes everybody.
If you can't imagine it, or beyond what you can and couldn't imagine has probably happened here musically wise.
With other venues, they just kind of want cover bands or whatever, just some country stuff. But over here, you have so much diversity that, like, you know what I mean? Like, they let anyone come in here and express their art, which that's the most beautiful thing of all.
It's one of the more laid-back places. Like, I love that you can get a mix of fucking punk rock, hip-hop, thrash, dark metal, emo, indie, all in the same fucking place. Like, that's kind of unheard of, at least in Evansville.
I think that's what I really like about PG. So if you want to come here on a night like tonight, there's, like, crazy metal stuff going on with people, I think, punching each other in the face. I didn't quite see. You can do that, or you can come when there's, like, folk and watch a folk show. And I've seen both those types of music on the same night before, even. Like, it's weird. There's nothing like PG. There probably won't be too many things like PG in the future. And that's sad.
There were shows where there were 125 people in here and we lost money at the bar because no one bought anything. And it was still a successful night because people had a good time and the music was great. It is very important to me that people do concern themselves with each other and the sense of community, but I think the mission is just really to have a space that's not so, well, see how that turned out, not so concerned with money, but is concerned with the art itself and the music.
Oh, yeah, thanks, man, I appreciate it.
Is this presidential show? Holy shit!
If it wasn't for PG, I don't think we would ever have had any of the friends that we have right now or any of the relationships we have.
No, definitely like, not.
It's because of this place that we really connected with everyone that we know now, and like, I wouldn't be who I am and what I want to be if it wasn't for this place.
We wouldn't have played tonight.
We wouldn't have ever played.
No, yeah, we would have never played if we didn't come here those nights.
This was the first place that opened its doors and let us do whatever we wanted to do. And through that, we found our sound, and we found confidence, and we found that people reciprocate and love what we do. And seeing that response and that reciprocation from the crowd helped us grow and become more confident and helped our sound shape into what it is.
This has been a breeding ground for true artists. I've seen people grow, develop, and even hit their plateau and then even going even higher in this place. So, you know, it's allowed opportunities for countless people. To have a place like this that provides an open door for those who want to create, those who want to make more of themselves, those who want to create events, you know, that's beautiful, you know? It's like, I've gotten to hear people say that they were inspired by the music that I've made, by the music that my bros have made, by the music that everyone in here has made. And that means more than anything.
if you want to start and you want to start getting to a performance level, you know, PG's is going to be home for you. The love in there is just something to hold another level, you know what I mean? And it's real.
Friends who have known make music for a long time come through, and people grow and move away and do awesome things elsewhere, and seeing newer generations of people coming through.
Those people need places to play. When I was 16, I needed a place to play.
Todd would give anyone a chance to play here. No matter if it's first show or whatever, if you're terrible, he'll just like, I'll just keep giving you a chance because you want to do your thing. And I'm so rad.
Yeah. Anything. If you want to just come like scream a bunch of cuss words in a microphone.
Yeah.
And chug hams. You're welcome to do that here.
I was definitely going to have it all ages, even if that meant struggling.
And we're so lucky that we came here fucking 14 years old and it was cool. Everything was cool. We're only 18. We've been going here for like 4 years and nothing would, I mean, just everything. It's like a chain reaction. Like you just can't stop. You know, what the place inspires, the bands, you know, even just like hanging out with people here, and even if you're not in a band, even if you don't make art, whatever, just having friends, having people that understand you, don't judge you.
Having fun at a show.
It's a safe space.
PG has been, like, for a lot of people, like, the only place to really play. I mean, you got all these bars in town that don't give a fuck about anyone making their own music. All they do is book the 40-year-old dads who
AC/DC covers.
Want to play some rock and roll, and they cover some Guns N' Roses and fucking AC/DC. Even if you're an 18-year-old and that's how you want to play music, you fucking can't. Everything is age-restricted. PG, yeah. Thank God, was all ages.
Yeah.
It's opened my mind a whole lot. Like, I'm a lot more open-minded whenever it comes to music and different styles of music and genres, and it's helped me understand artists and how weird we all are.
I am a lioness, and PG let me roar.
Right, exactly. And the goal is to create a mixtape of like 10 to 12 super hot tracks that blow people's minds and make them go, oh my god, Evansville has its own sound, let's do this.
So we want to try to create a huge buzz by the end of this.
To see Charles standing there and seeing his vision come to life through us, and then the collaborations that have happened after that and are still continuing, the connections, the friendships, the camaraderie, and the doors that open, I mean, that's exactly what it was about.
So when we finally got together, I mean, like, the people I've been looking up to since before I even started making music, you know, we were just hanging out upstairs, just, like, bonding through music. And it's like, and that was the lock-in, and the show happened, and it's like, we brought all these people out.
And that's all because of PG. PG allowed us in their home, let us make it our home, and we all became one in there for one night, and, in the process, we have all walked out those doors greater than we were when we walked in.
Like, we all just hung out here until like from sundown to sun up and tried to bounce ideas around and work with each other, and it was really interesting. I think it was a positive thing, because again, to credit PG, up until that point, I didn't see personally, and this is just my perspective, but like I didn't see as much mingling of like the hip-hop community around here. Like, I would meet people and they would have their people that they would know about, and they would do their thing, and then there'd be other people and they did their thing. But like, it was, this place started slowly, I feel like, uniting a bunch of people, and that was awesome.
The time that we went in there to start like kind of working on tracks and artists working with producers and stuff like that, that's what got me, because I was just like, I was working with people I haven't worked with before, people I planned on working with, and people that I just didn't know what they were necessarily bringing to the table or how good they were. And so I found out a lot of that stuff, like, that day, the next day, like, and so I was, you know, I love it.
For everybody, history. History. Everybody in this picture, like, made a mark in Evansville, like, in PG, a year of hip-hop, whatever. We made the hip-hop community with this. We let people know in Evansville, like, this, there is a hip-hop community. There is one. And we really showcased real talent. We did it. It was a beautiful moment. It's a beautiful moment.
Fast forward, like, we did the first show, and, you know, we put a whole mixtape together with these people, mm-hmm. and we grew together. People learned. I learned. I taught. You know what I'm saying? We threw that first show. You know, it was over 100 people there. Well, over 100 people in there, and it was like very satisfying because it wasn't like, hey, you do this, you do this, you do this. It was like, we all do it, you know what I'm saying? And it exploded.
Available soon too. I'll send you a link.
Got you. I ain't gonna listen to it too much because I ain't trying to cry like that. But I'm gonna listen to it when I'm alone, like alone with like all my Drake and Weekend.
Tons of emotions, like everywhere. You know, it was definitely hard to kind of process all of that because you know you had people that were like excited and pumped to do their thing for PG, and you had people that were you know acting out. Emotionally, you had people that, you know, were sad and people that just kind of, without words, you know, like lots of hugs, lots of love, just, you know, it was a good night. I enjoyed it, you know, obviously nothing goes perfectly, so, you know, but, you know, you find the perfect things of the night and that's what it's all about.
This was such a cool year. We got together, what, 30 plus people, producers and MCs and stuff, to get together and collaboratively work on stuff. Stuff wouldn't have been possible without everybody getting together and make stuff happen. It's like Legos. Like, you can't have a wall if there's a piece missing, because then you got a window. It's not just a wall, you got stuff you can see through. And I don't like that, because it's not a wall.
It was bittersweet. The whole night.
Yeah! Was... Hey, yo!
That's it.
Oh, that
yeah,
that's
plays tonight pretty much.
I'm sorry, Joey.
It was bittersweet. It was the best show that we've ever played, and one of the most important nights of our lives for sure. This place means everything to us, and I'm looking forward to the future. This group of people can do amazing things, and it's just gonna be a matter of time before we do.
This is a special place. This will be the only time, the last time, that all of us.
Man, the only thing I can say is shit, this was a vibe, man. This is something that needed to happen. It's something that needs to continue happening if you can find a way to do it.
I'm hoping that this community, like, it will be the response from this event that it this is not a one and done. Like, so if you bring 200 people, we're going to automatically start looking at what's next.
The hope is, like, as long as there's somebody like Todd, or there's somebody like me, or somebody like you, or whoever is watching, I don't know. As long as you have that hope inside of you, you'll create something just as great for people like me to come to and to express themselves. I wouldn't even be linked up with the people that I am now because of PG. It did not fail. It succeeded in so many ways that a lot of people don't even fucking know and won't know until we like tell that story. Thank you, PG. Thank you so much. Appreciate you. I love you.
Yeah, where else are you gonna get to do your thing and be like, I don't know, I'm just a young kid, I wanna try this thing out, man. And yeah, then exactly. Like, yeah. Where else is, you know, where is I gonna, like, wanna book this kid coming out or whatever? That's like, that's we need places like PG to harbor that, like, you know, all the music and stuff and everything. There's so much young talent out there, and you gotta get out there, even if you're terrible the first time, you gotta get out there and start doing it to understand what you're trying to do or whatever, you know, so. Yeah, yeah, they super need places like all ages venues to do this. And to get weird with, not even.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's not sleep on or squander what we've created in this place. Let's reach for greater and better things. And I hope to see PG's sign come up again in a bigger building, in a better place, with more people, with more capital, and even better than ever. And I really want to put my word on that's going to happen, because I don't see any other way for this to work out. We're not going to allow anybody else to take our home. You know, they might take the building, but fuck it, it's a building. This is still our home. This is the place that took us in when didn't nobody else give a shit. And just like they did that for us, now we have to keep that shit alive.
This place means so much to us. This will always be our home. This is where we started. These guys first gave us the chance, and this will always be our home.
Who knows what it is that one day that we'll become, and when we're in another interview being asked, so how did this all begin? We can remember PG and know that Todd gave us a space to be who we really could be.
I know so many people that just enjoy coming here so much, and they're not gonna let the building closing like just stop them from playing, from being in bands, to touring, to recording their music, anything, making art.
If we weren't playing PG, we would book shows at cabins or find
any shelters,
any odd
houses,
spot to throw them. So I think the energy and the personalities that PG helped grow is just gonna go right back to that and make that a stronger.
Yeah,
I think everybody who leaves here is gonna take a little piece of PG's with them, and nobody will forever forget. PG's forever. Ayo, hashtag Ayo. At the end of the day, you know, part of me, PG's part of me, man. Hopefully I left some of my legacy in the walls, you know what I mean? It's a crazy thing, bro.
No, it's sad, it's sad, it is sad, but it's cool that this space existed, and I think it existed a lot longer than we thought it was going to.
That's true.
And I think everyone kind of knew from the get-go that it wasn't going to last forever.
Nothing lasts forever.
But I mean, I just mean like...
Even cold November rain.
Shut up. Yeah, that.
I just hope that, like, Todd specifically, since this is his baby, I hope that he finds that creative energy that he has to find a new vessel and to pursue something else that's, you know, as ambitious and as cool as what he did with this. So primarily, like, that's my main send-off, is I hope Todd continues to try to do cool things for the community like he's done a really good job of doing, and I think deserves more credit for that
for sure.
People that haven't been here, man, y'all missed out. You know, and hopefully there's you know, something like it soon so y'all can experience it. And to the PG family, like, man, I love all y'all. I miss hanging out here and just chilling and cutting up with people and joking and stuff. To the AO family, man, like, I love all y'all, like, ancestors. Like, you know, y'all was there for me probably the hardest time of my life, and like, kept me busy whenever I needed something to keep me busy, like. So, yeah, I love all y'all. Just, you know, keep loving everybody, you know.
We're forever grateful for every night that we've got to spend here, and for all the people that we met, including Todd, and every
changed your life forever. It really did.
It definitely did. I think this night made us all feel a lot of feels. I don't think you can really put into words what PG means to us, or to you, or to any of them. It's home, and we've never had a venue like this, and it's sad to see it go. But we're so thankful that we were able to do this one more time and be all together and be with you and be with them. So how I felt, I feel really happy.
It feels sad. It feels sad to me. It feels kind of low.
What feels about it all day? Just the feeling that this is the last thing ever.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's been like a week-long feeling. It's just like the most intense tonight, I think.
Yeah. I got emotional. I'm sad. It's pretty much over as far as, not AO, but this construct of PG. Not PG itself, but this physical construct is. It's got 5-6 more days to it, and that's it. Like, we come on the 31st, and we're going to have a fucking party. We're going to have a blast. We're going to have a ball. I've got champagne, more than this stuff. I'm buying more champagne. In the night, we're gonna pop bottles, make a fucking mess. We're gonna have a good fucking time. I miss PG already, even though it's not gone.
Turn up the camera for Ben.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh shit.
I don't know if I want to use the controller, Kitty.
That's fine.
Hey, Mitch.
Murphy's the co-owner of PG as of today, according to this Channel 25 guy.
Did he leave?
Changes happening in Evansville and all that shit. Here for y'all, if you want to like talk or
you know, if you feel like any sort of weirdness in your community or anything like that, you need to do something about it and realize that it is going to be all right.
Everybody's going to be fine. It's going to be awesome.
The art scene will continue to thrive. The music's, yeah, it's all good. We're fine.